Hey everyone, thank you so much for watching this week's installment of Reasonable Radiance. Today I'm going to show you how to have an inexpensive, basic three-step smokey eye featuring the Wet n Wild Comfort Zone palette. I was really rather inspired by this particular monochrome color in the palette. It's just got flexes of gold and green, and it's absolutely gorgeous. Now, as usual, we're going to begin by priming our eyelids. Here I'm using Urban Decay's Eyeshadow Primer Potion in Original. We're just going to pat that on and blend it out up into the brow bone. Then for an added base to really bring out the more warmer tones inside of the monochrome color, I'm going to be using NYX's Jumbo Eyeshadow Pencil in Pure Gold. Just using a flat, stiff brush, I'm going to blend out the pigment so that it's not too harsh, and also so that it lays as a base and in the end won't crease. Now I'm taking Cottage Cheese by NYX and going to use this as the base for the highlight color. Taking a large flat eyeshadow brush, this one is by Sigma, I'm going to be dipping that into the darkest color in the palette, which is the monochrome color, and I'm just going to apply that onto the moving lid and a little bit upward up against the crease. Here is the real trick to this look, and it's very simple. All you need to do is take a little bit of the pigment onto your brush and flip it upward. Then you're going to feather it out up towards the brow bone. This is just going to establish that gradient effect that we want for the smoky eye. Taking a brighter medium toned color from the palette, this one has a taupey gray hue to it. I'm going to drag it along the crease and just below the brow bone and along the outer corner of the eye to really go for that feathered out gradient look and demolish any of the harshness left over from the deep monochrome color. This is going to really help establish that gradient effect that I'm going for with this particular look. Lastly, selecting the highlight color of choice, this one in the palette happens to be a pretty good dupe of Rice Paper by MAC. I'm going to pat that along the brow bone just below the eyebrow for that last bit of dimension. Then taking a large fluffy brush, this one is by Sigma, I'm going to blend everything out to dissipate any harshness and really create that soft feathered effect. Next, it's time for some eyeliner, I tightlined both of Susanna's upper and lower waterlines and added a pop of black to along the lower lashes. Then taking a concealer, I removed any fallout and re-brightened below her eye. Apply the mascara of your choice, and you could also use false lashes if you like. And voila, you're done. Pretty easy.
All right, guys. So the finished look looks like this. Isn't she gorgeous? Yes, she is. I hope you enjoy this look, and I hope it's really helpful for you. And basically, all you need is three. I mean, sometimes all you really need is two colors. Like, you could use a darker tone color and then a lighter tone color. But really, what makes the color so it's not so potent, it's not so dark, is the highlight, and that can really make or break the look, I think, in my opinion. So as long as you have the darker tone with the lighter tone and it kind of fades out into it, kind of with the feathery gradient type effect, then it just works. So I really hope that this is helpful for you, and I hope you use it. And it's pretty inexpensive if you ask me. I mean, I can't find my, oh, here it is. 97 cents for an eyeliner that's hecka creamy. Like, look at this. I mean, it glides right on. So, again, I hope this was helpful. Look at Sue's posing in the background there. So, and yeah, enjoy your evening, and thank you so much for watching. And please remember to comment, rate, and subscribe. And I will see you next time for the next Reasonable Radiance video. So, thanks, bye guys! Ha ha!